Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to talk about JSON and how to fetch nested objects in an array. I was asked by from a person in the community how could he actually fetch a certain, he wanted a certain spaceship. Could he use the name of the spaceship? And the short answer is of course no, unless you actually create it as a key. But let us go look at it. And at the same time, the reason why I'm writing Spring Boot and also Kotlin right here is that the Kotlin Conf in Copenhagen ran this week. So to honor that, I'm writing Kotlin tonight, and also because I think it's a lot of fun to write Kotlin. So we are playing around with Kotlin tonight, and I'll if you're a Java developer, then I'll tell you some of the differences along as we go. But his problem was that we had this JSON right here, where we have the space station, then we have the spaceships right here, and we have, it's a list, you can see it's a square bracket right there, so it's a list of spaceships, and then we have all these spaceships down here. And of course the JSON that we used last time was much larger, and then the person from the community wanted to know how to actually go in and fetch maybe the Eagle spaceship right here and get that out. Could he use just the name in his programming language or not? And the short answer there was actually no. He actually has to go to each of these elements one by one and then find the element from the criteria that he sets, and then he actually extracts this the spaceship. Usually, of course, we would have an ID like ID1 right here. Then we will have ID2 right here, and then of course we usually find and deal with our objects with IDs instead of just having them with the name right here. And our situation, if he really wanted to refer to the spaceships by name, then he could actually create his space his JSON structure a little bit different. Let's say that we created the spaceships as an object instead of an array. That means that all this code down here, I'll just delete that. And when I say delete, I'll just place it in the clipboard. I'm cutting it, so Control X on that. And then we have the spaceships right here. And then of course he could have something like Eagle, and then he could create his Eagle down here with the name of the spaceship. He wouldn't of course need to have the name. Then he would just have the ID, which was a 2 or something. I'm not sure it was the same ID as last time, but it doesn't matter. Then we have the crew members could be some number right there. And then he could have his next spaceship, that could be the Hawk, like that. And then you will create the object like this. And if you create your data structure like this, of course it's not very flexible, because if you intended to have a list with a lot of spaceships, then it's not good to use the key, because then it's very difficult just to collect all the spaceships and say delete on them or whatever you want to. Then you actually need to know the key. So I would definitely not recommend this. I would recommend the other structure that we actually made with the JSON. I would recommend this structure right here, where we have the spaceships and then an array, then each spaceship right here. And yes, we need to find it by maybe the name, if that's what we want to find it by, or the ID, if that's what we want to find it by in our code. But let's create an example in Kotlin and see how it's done actually. I'll just delete my output right here. And yeah, let me minimize this window right here. I have created a project by pressing File, New Project right here. Then I chose Spring Initializer. I'm using JDK SDK 13 right now. Next, then I gave it a group name and an artifact name. I chose Gradle just because I prefer Gradle. And then I chose Java 11. Next, then I ticked off Lombok, which I'm actually not using. Sorry, I have to remove that again. It's just old habits. I always tick off Lombok. But when you're using Kotlin, you can actually not use Lombok. It's not totally supported yet, as I know. You're welcome to correct me. The last time I checked, it was not supported with Kotlin. So I ticked off Spring Web, and then I ticked off Mongo, Spring Data Mongo. That's because I was planning to do a video about Kotlin and the Mongo template, so I would like to prepare for that also. So then I ticked off Mongo, but if you don't want to, then just skip this part for now. just tick off Spring Web, then I press next, next, finish, and then I ended up with this project right here. The reason why I'm creating this on before starting the video is because that as soon as this project is done, then a lot of indexing in IntelliJ starts a lot of indexing, and it takes some time, which of course I would like to spare you from. So then I create a package right here called Space, and if you want to, if you are curious, this is actually how the application looks like. So if you're a Java developer, you have the usual annotation right here on top of the class. We don't need the brackets up here in Java. So yeah, and then we have the function right here. And methods are just called function when it's Kotlin. So and this yeah. But I made some Kotlin videos if you want to know basic stuff about the language, the Kotlin language, of course, also. I'll explain some of the stuff as we go along. What I want to do right now, I want to create a service that picks up this JSON file right here. That it's located in the resource folder, so it's pretty easy to pick up with Object Mapper. So I want to pick up this JSON file here, right here with something called a Space Station service, which we will just create right now. Space Station service. If only I could spell Space Station service like this. And this is a Kotlin class. And I'm just annotating it with service as if it was a Java class. There's no difference there. And then we have the... yeah, that's actually it. Then I want to create a function which returns, which should be called Space Station. When you're dealing with Kotlin, then the first thing you actually are talking about is actually you write fun because it's a function. And it's also fun to write Kotlin, so maybe that's why they kept this word also. But then the next thing actually you need to write in Java, you need to give the return type as the first thing. But in Kotlin, the first thing you need to give is actually the name of the method, which is right here, Space Station. And then in the end, you can give the return type. It's also a bit more logical way of thinking. So that's my opinion. Space Station, like this. And we have not created the Space Station yet, so we get an error. I press Alt Enter in IntelliJ, and then I will create my class. And in Kotlin, you can create as many classes as you want in the same file, but I like still to have one class per file, so I extract this to a separate file. Thank you very much, IntelliJ. Then it creates a class like this. The Space Station, it needs to have the same fields as the JSON right here. So it needs to have a name, inhabitants, and the spaceships right here. So those three fields are the ones we need. Oh, we just undo that. I'm going to copy these just to remember all the fields. Go to my Space Station. And in Kotlin, there's something called a data class. It's almost the same as if you're actually in Lombok, if you're using Lombok, and then you annotated your Java class with data, add data. Because what you get is actually, you get the equals method, and you also get the toString methods overridden. There are some other differences in Kotlin, so it's not exactly the same, but it's close to. So if you're used to Java and Lombok, then this would not be foreign for you. Then you create the constructor in Kotlin. You create that as in the first line along with the class, and it actually makes sense. And this is called the primary constructor. And when you are creating a Java data class like this, then the first thing is you need to give: should it be mutable or immutable? Should we be able to change the value later on or not? And by default, we should try to use val. But when there's a data class like this, I would like to change the properties as we go, so that I'm making this mutable, and then I'm writing name. And it has the type string, and then we have an inhabitants. This is an integer, and in Kotlin you save some typing there because you only need to type int. Of course, I know that usually you would just type int also in Java, and then you would press Control Space, and then it will write an integer instead. Or in Java, you will have the integer like this instead, the primitive type instead of the object type. Then we have the spaceships, and that is a list, and that is a Kotlin list from a collection, and it also has generics right here, so I can give it a generic. I want to say that this is a spaceship, so it contains a list of spaceships. Now I get an error because spaceships has not been created yet, so let me just create that. Create class spaceship. Extract to separate file. Okay. I want to go back to my Space Station actually just for a minute, because, and I'm going to delete these lines right here. I just had them so I could remember them. There is something called a secondary constructor, What this actually does is, actually right now we will have these as member variables also. That's also a thing that will happen when you place the a private constructor like this, and then you place the variables up here, and you have a data class, then you will also get these as member variables. So we don't need to create member variables. Usually we'll have a private private string name. If it was Java, then we would write stuff like that. But we don't need to write that. That is done behind the back. It's done implicit. But what we need to do is we need to create a secondary constructor, because when we deserialize this from JSON, then we need a default constructor. We need a constructor without any arguments on it, or else Jackson will get angry at me. So I need to create a secondary constructor, and that is done by creating a secondary constructor like this. This means that it doesn't take any arguments. I'm not placing anything there. But now I need to show how will this use the primary constructor. So that means that the secondary constructor needs to use the primary constructor. So that means I need to write this, and then I need to say which values should we actually have in here. The name should just be not set in my situation right here. It's also a good way of actually avoiding null pointer exceptions, because now we're actually setting some values even though we have a constructor. But so in Java all these would just be null by default. So let me just, of course, we could also set these the member variables to these values in Java, but it's just not as obvious as it is in Kotlin to do so. So, okay, let me just see here. We have not set, and then some inhabitants, 0 or maybe minus 1. Then we can see, you know, output if none of these has been set. Then we have the spaceship. And the cool thing also in Kotlin, then we can just write list off and then just keep a blank list. Then we have created a list right here. So this is our constructor, this is our primary constructor, and this is our secondary constructor. Very, very cool. Then I go to my spaceship right here. It's also a data class. Like this. And yes, we need to give it some arguments, and it has an ID, name, and crew number. So let's give it that. So we have variable, or maybe should, yeah, that's okay. Variable ID, int, and then we have the var name string, and then we have the var crew members on the ship, and that was an int, yes, like this. And again, now we need to create the default constructor. The secondary constructor. That's to make it's only to make Jackson happy when we map the JSON to the Kotlin objects. So we have the constructor, this, and then we say the ID should be -1 as default. The name should just be not set, and the number of crew members should just be -1 also. And again, I don't need to finish my lines with the semicolon as I do in Java, which I also really, really like. I don't know, I think it hurts my fingers a little bit every time, because I need to hold shift and then I need to press the comma button right to make the semicolon. I also like Java a lot, just so you know. It's not like there's only Kotlin or something like that. I'm not religious regarding the languages. So let me just check right here. Yeah, so this was the space station. We need to return the space station. We need to use the object mapper. So now I'm creating a mapper equals object mapper. This is Jackson, object mapper. So we have a new object mapper right there. And then we need to something called in Spring, we can use, there's something called class path resource. And this is actually a class path resource because it is on a class path. So it means that I can actually say resource. I can also just say JSON file like this equals and then class path resource, and then we set a string, and I just write space station.json like this, and then I can write mapper, and then we can say read value. And then we need an input stream. Then I say my JSON file dot input stream. Then I need to say which class do we want to map this to, space station. space station. And if you want to use the Java class here, and that's exactly what we need to do, then we need to write the two colons, and then I need to write Java, you know, class.java. This is the same as, this would be the same as space station.class in Java, but we just need to write it like this because we are in Kotlin right now, so we need to say that this is a Java class that we want to return, and that's just how to do that. And val station equals to, and then we're returning that. I could also do it in 1.9, but I would like to be a little bit explicit right here. So return station. So we have the space station there, and maybe there are errors, maybe not. We'll just check that. I'll update IntelliJ later. Yes, thank you very much. Then I'll create my test. I'll go in the end of my class, and then I'll just press Alt Enter, create test. Then I'll tick off space station. Thank you very much. Okay. Okay, rewrite. I actually already made a test already. I just forgot to delete it, so I'll just hurry up and delete it. Actually, let me just delete it. It would be like this if I hadn't written anything. Then this class here would actually be created. So we have something with scope here internal. Again here, I would like to annotate this with Spring Boot test. Because then we get the whole Spring context up and running. So we have the application that will just start then inject itself, so everything actually works. And then I need to write something called late init var, and then we need to say this is a space station service like this. And I think, and then we can annotate this with auto wired. We need the late init because usually everything is actually initialized in the constructor. So when we're dealing with Kotlin, we need this late init because we're actually saying that when we create this, then we want to auto wire this. That means that also that we want to initialize this space station service a little bit later. So that's just how it is with when you're dealing with Kotlin. I think there was some kind of workaround to this. I'll dig into this afterwards. That's actually a new way of writing this with JUnit 5 and forward. Then we can write this line a little bit differently. But for now, if you're using JUnit 4, then just write late init, and then the variable right here, and then auto wired like this. So it's almost like in Java, but you just need to late init in front. Then we have the test right here. Okay, let us get to the test. Space station service. Space station, we get a space station right there. Introduce new local variable. Yes, thank you very much, space station. Thank you very much. So now I have my space station. Let us print it out just to see if it works. Print line, my space station. Then I can use dollar signs right here and you can write space station like this. Let's see if it works. Let's see if it works this far. Yes, what does it say here? Space station, peace and harmony, inhabitants, spaceship, we get the right IDs on. I'm shading a little bit, I know, so I'll pull up the, like this. Now it's just above my head. So here we have the name Hawk, crew members 20, and we have the spaceship with 2, we have the Eagle, we have the Swan with the crew members of 123. So now let us actually solve the problem that the person in the community asked for. Space station dot spaceships. We want to go to the spaceships. We want to go pick out the Eagle spaceship, and then we want to print that one out. So we just want to grab that. And in Kotlin, it's actually very, very easy. We connect, there's a method called find. This will find the first ship that matches the predicate, the criteria that we put in here. This needs to be a boolean that we have on the right side right here. So we have a ship dot name, and then we can write 2 equal signs, and then I can write Eagle, and then I can assign this to a new local variable, which is Eagle ship. And then I can also print this one out, print line. And I can use the double equals right here. I don't need to write something with equals or something, because yeah, it actually means equals, and we have the yeah. So that's actually it. So yeah, so it's very yeah. It's much yeah. It gives more meaning. Let me just check right here. I wanted to write my spaceship, and then I wanted to use the dollar again. Dollar equals ship. Like this. Of course, in Java, we would run the string dot format, and then we would format it with the percentage s instead. This is also much much easier. So let me just run my test right here. Yes, that's it. And here we have it. My spaceship. And then it says spaceship in front. That's okay. And then it says ID2, the Eagle, and crew 23. I'm so proud of myself. We wrote some cool Kotlin code right here. And we found the nested object inside the list. We found the right spaceship that we actually wanted to find. So that we right there. This was a huge success. Yes, that's actually it for tonight. So thank you very much for watching. I hope to see you again very soon. Have a great evening. Bye-bye.